Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy, the United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan.
On December 7th, 1941, the forces of Japan bombed Pearl Harbor. On December 8th, 1941, Franklin Roosevelt declares war on Japan. A few days later, Germany declares war on America, hence creating America's involvement in World War II.
Soldiers, sailors, and airmen of the Allied Expeditionary Force, you are about to embark upon the great crusade toward which we have striven these many months. The eyes of the world are upon you. The hopes and prayers of liberty-loving people everywhere march with you. In company with our brave allies and brothers in arms on other fronts, you will bring about the destruction of the German war machine, the elimination of Nazi tyranny over the oppressed peoples of Europe, and security for ourselves in a free world. Your task will not be an easy one. Your enemy is well trained, well equipped, and battle hardened. He will fight savagely. But this is the year 1944. Much has happened since the Nazi triumphs of 1940-41. The United Nations have inflicted upon the Germans great defeats in open battle, man to man. Our air offensive has seriously reduced their strength in the air and their capacity to wage war on the ground. Our home fronts have given us an overwhelming superiority in weapons and munitions of war, and placed at our disposal great reserves of trained fighting men. The tide has turned. The free men of the world are marching together to victory. I have full confidence in your courage, devotion to duty, and skill in battle. We will accept nothing less than full victory. Good luck, and let us all beseech the blessing of Almighty God upon this great and noble undertaking.
Happening, and it's a very unusual bonding.
We knew that we could depend on each other. And so we were a close-knit group.
Just brave. So brave is unbelievable. And I don't know anybody that I admire more than Bill Garnier and Joe Toy. And they were very, very special.
I'm just one part of the big war, that's all. One little part. And I'm proud to be a part of it. Sometimes it makes me cry.
The real men, the real heroes, are the fellas that are still buried over there and those that come home to be buried.
Seemed like you figured that you thought that you could do just about anything. And after the war was over and you came back out, why, you lost a lot of that. Or at least I did. I lost all that confidence.
Well, you're hoping to stay alive, that's all. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Henry V was talking to his men. He said, from this day to the ending of the world, we in it shall be remembered. We lucky few, we band of brothers. For he who today sheds his blood with me shall be my brother.
I cherish the memories of a question my grandson asked me the other day when he said, Grandpa, were you a hero in the war? Grandpa said, no. But I served in a company of heroes.